How's it going, boys and girls? It's your boy Raymond back up in here with another review. And today we have got a very special album today. It is The Weeknd's new album, After Hours. Now, I've been waiting for this album for the past while, ever since Blinding Lights came out. I was super excited, loved the 80s retro vibe that The Weeknd had going on. Super cool mix of like this synth pop, 80s techno, loved it. And then we got After Hours, the single that came out a few weeks later. Loved that song, almost loved it even more than Blinding Lights. 6 minutes basically of The Weeknd being toxic as fuck, which I absolutely adore. Definitely one of my favorites off the album even. It's week two of quarantine, about to go on week three. And we've got The Weeknd's new album to lift us out of this gloomy paranoia going on right now. Shout out to The Weeknd. I think it's already hitting like 900 million streams on Spotify, and it's only like the third day that it's been out. So let me start by talking about the first track. So the first track is Alone Again. If you wanted to have any idea about what the album really symbolizes in terms of concept and in terms of just overall sound, the opening track encompasses the whole album very well and sort of immediately puts you on this roller coaster that just kind of twists and turns throughout this whole album, going through Abel's mind, just like going through his emotions and his relationship issues ever since My Dear Melancholy. We've got this really big buildup going on, a lot of the synths, a lot of the production in the background, and then just turns into Tron Legacy when the beat comes in. I feel like I'm flying. After Blinding Lights and After Hours, everybody was kind of curious on which, on if he was going to go towards a more pop-oriented sound, similar to what we got off of Beauty Behind the Madness, or if he was going to go towards all the way back to like a sort of House of Balloons, really dark, gritty R&B pop kind of sound. If anything, it's almost like a combination of the two, but then the thing that you can notice really about this album is that there's definitely a lot of Daft Punk influence that still carried over from Starboy, especially with the really heavy booming synths that are usually going on in the background behind a lot of the hip hop and R&B beats in the background. There's just these super booming synths throughout like the whole album. And they kind of take you by surprise because you don't really know that they're coming, but you just get this whole huge grand production on like every track, and all of the production, the synths, the beats, the drums, they all sound super clean. Some of them even sound super eerie, as if you're as if you just got dropped off from like a party bus. And now you're kind of walking home and it's dark and there's no one in the streets and whatnot. You know, it's kind of like that eerie, unsafe feeling. But yet The Weeknd's kind of in the back of your head, just kind of guiding you through like this whole night adventure. It's what this whole album kind of feels like. And the opening track does a beautiful job of doing that. It's just, the beat doesn't even drop until about like halfway through. And the intro is just him kind of giving all these little vocal verses, just like kind of here and there, flashing about in the background, putting you into the headspace of the album. Then we get to Too Late, and Too Late, I'm not gonna lie, is a little unexpected. It's a little weird, the placement of the second track on here, just because the way that Alone Again started, it made this seem like it was gonna be some super huge, grand R&B cut, and then Too Late is a little bit of a jarring transition from the first track, just because it immediately goes into sort of this really hoppy R&B house track. Got this really cute come up, and it just drops. Don't get me wrong, I really like it. It's just the placement of it was a little unexpected and a little jarring from the first cut. If it was maybe like the third or fourth track, I feel like it would have fit better, but still a really good track. And then we get to Hardest to Love, which sounds like a Sega Genesis soundtrack with The Weeknd on it. Oh, we're going here. Sonic's going ham. It's probably my least favorite on the album, just because I don't really like The Weeknd on this track. It just doesn't sound as appealing to me. Scared to Live, saw that SNL video. Absolutely beautiful track, beautiful track. Super doubtful of how to continue with the future after all this relationship that he just got out of. Talking about her, like, oh, you know, can you move on? Can I move on? You know, because I'm scared. I don't know if I can do it. That kind of thing. So you're scared to live again. Scared to live again. You always miss the chance of falling for someone. You can't hate this song. It's just so pretty. Okay? You can say whatever you want about it. It's just so pretty. So pretty, honestly. Snowchild is a super cool track because that basically goes into the mind and the past of Abel himself, kind of talking about his past in Toronto and going into like his childhood and his come up, getting a super little personal track. Could have seen Drake possibly coming in on here. I feel like that would have been a Drake track in the first place if it wasn't for The Weeknd. But I really liked it. You know, he's kind of spitting some verses on there. You know, I like it. I like it. It's pretty cute. I've been speaking to my nightmares and to big dreams. Whole squad mobbing, even though we only six deep. I was singing notes while my niggas played with six keys. Walking in the snow before I ever made my wrist freeze. I was blowing smoke, had me dizzy like a lesbian. Niggas had no homes, we were living in the dead streets. And I had nothing to believe in. I love this beat. This beat is super cool. Yeah, I like a little drop right there. That little background synth drop is pretty cool. Escape from LA is like it's probably the Smokey Room-esque vibe track of this whole album, honestly. The beginning of Escape from LA sounds like an old, eerie, I don't even know, like an old Tory Lanez song, almost. That's the way that it cuts in and out, and then it kind of starts with this super slow, trailing R&B pace, you know? I really like it. Basically talking about how everything that he's experienced in LA has led to him being just like even more depressed and even more sad. He's had a lot of bad experiences in LA, and so he just wants to get out of LA, as the chorus says. And so it's just about him and his struggles with his environment, basically. Get to Heartless, which the single came out like a few weeks ago around when Blinding Lights came out. I'm not a super huge fan of it. I do kind of like the beat. It's just I don't really like The Weeknd over top of the beat. I think it would have worked better if it was like maybe a Big Sean, or maybe someone like that. I'm kind of blanking right now. But I just don't really like The Weeknd over Heartless. I don't really think it sounds super fitting for how he is used to singing. So this beat is still kind of cool though. So that's just me, but it's still a decent track. Then we get Faith, which is right before Blinding Lights, and Faith gives a really good lead in to Blinding Lights and makes Blinding Lights feel even more toxic than it really is. But basically Faith is just him talking about trying to continue on from this thing that he had with a girl. He's trying to get her back, trying to win her back, but he's in this really messed up headspace, and he's also, you know, he's on drugs and getting drunk and just not being in the best environment for himself. And so it gets super toxic by the end of the track, especially with the outro, which is super pretty, and he just kind of, his vocals kind of fade into the background, and it gives a little bit of like a haunting vibe for him, which I thought was pretty cool. You get Blinding Lights again, fantastic track, loved it. You don't even have to do too much, you can tell me I'm just a touch. On top of that, you get, after Blinding Lights, you get In Your Eyes, which is a very interesting track because I was not expecting after Blinding Lights for him to keep up the whole sort of like in your face, the whole like eye concept, you know, because then you have Blinding Lights and you have In Your Eyes, you know, the girl's blinded from Abel and like Blinding Lights. And then In Your Eyes is like, he's kind of in your head. The track doesn't really portray that much, just because there's a lot, it's actually a very funky jazz track, kind of. There's like saxophones and like a little brass quartet in the background that's kind of like playing a lot of these really cool like samples and sound effects in the background. I don't know if he actually had like a band come in there. Probably. He's got enough money. I mean, you know, it's The Weeknd. This is some Duran Duran synths right here. I thought that was a really cool addition to it. The whole outro is just like this sax solo, backed up by these brass hits. Sounds super cool. And then we got this next one, Save Your Tears. That one hits a little bit different, just because that's at the point where he's gotten so toxic for this chick that she just despises him and she does not want to deal with him whatsoever. And so she's on like the brink of breaking, but Abel is just deciding to be an asshole and is just saying like, you know, no, you know, you can't do it, like, save your tears, you can't just cry like this and hope that everything's going to be okay. Like, you can't just do that, you know? I'm here for you, even though I broke your heart. I'm here for you. That is pure toxicity, but I love it. Another Duran Duran song. And then we get to one of my favorite tracks, interestingly enough, which is actually the interlude, Repeat After Me. I love the beat. I love the production. The lyrics is just this constantly repeating, funny enough, verse saying that, like, you're just fucking him. You don't love him. You know, saying like this. And he just keeps on repeating it. And it's just the peak of the album where Abel is the most like heartless and disgusting and toxic, because he is just repeatedly telling this girl that the guy that she's with right now is not better than he is, and that he is better than him, and they're just fucking around. But the relationship that he has, the relationship that Abel has with her, is stronger and better than the guy that she's fucking right now, because he doesn't have the emotional texture that the Weeknd has. That's some fucked up shit, man. Like, especially after what he just got through explaining to us in every track before. This man is nuts. This man's a dick. But I still love it. And then we get to After Hours, the single. Like I said, love it. Beautiful track. Absolutely beautiful track. Love all of the production. Love everything about this song. The beat drop. The huge, long intro. I forgot who it was. I believe Kevin Parker is on a few of the songs on this album. And you can really tell. He really brings a lot of color and texture to the production and to, like, the pianos and the synthesizers and a lot of the electronic features that go on behind a lot of the booming R&B beats. And then we get the last song, which is Until I Bleed Out. I'm still not sure how I completely feel about it, because after the grand opening from Alone Again, I was expecting like a super sad and dramatic closer. And I didn't really feel like Until I Bleed Out really gave that to you. I just kind of thought, you know, it was kind of cute. He's finally agreed with himself that he was going to keep fending for this girl until he bleeds out and until he dies, pretty much, which is like super messed up and cool. But I was expecting more of like a grand cinematic track that we got with the opener to really send the album out and really like have a smooth transition out of the mindset of the Weeknd in After Hours. But overall, it's a really beautiful album. Production is absolutely fantastic, as usual with a Weeknd album. Abel is sounding toxic as fuck for like a good 90% of this album, which I absolutely love. It's a beautiful mix between House of Balloons and with some Daft Punk influence from Starboy, and then as well as like some pop oriented aspects from Beauty Behind the Madness, and then a little bit of the airy, eerie vibes from My Dear Melancholy tossed in there. And well, it's a really cool retro kind of album, and I really love the sound of it. I think the sound of it is super cool for the time that it came out. Yeah, that's all I really had to say about it. I think I'm gonna be giving this one a 9 out of 10. It may or may not go down. It's kind of leaning more towards like an 8.5, but it still got me on a high right now, so I think I'm gonna keep it at a 9 out of 10. Amazing album, highly recommend. I mean, you've got all the time in the world now, since we're going on like week 3 of quarantine. So go listen to it. And also, on top of that, out of nowhere, Childish Gambino, aka Donald Glover, just decided to drop his new album yesterday, last night. I caught him in the act. I was checking YouTube, and he just dropped it, and then I checked Spotify, and it was on there, and I was like, what the hell's going on? So, we're gonna have to take a look at that, because it's a conceptual album. I'm gonna have to dive deep. It's gonna take a few listens. I've already listened to it once last night, because I was freaking out, but it's gonna take a few listens to really understand the concept. So I'm gonna be doing that. I'm gonna try to get this video out by Sunday night, and then hopefully I'm gonna try to get the Childish Gambino video out by Sunday or Monday night as well. Stay tuned for that, for sure. Like and subscribe and click that notification bell if you wanna stay updated on my videos. Like I said, I'm gonna try to be posting more on music and film reviews and stuff like that, since we're going on week 3 of quarantine, and we're gonna keep going on until like April, so we'll see what happens. That's After Hours by The Weeknd. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.